Hello and welcome back to my channel, or welcome here if you are new. Today we are doing some real life mom life cleaning, just some general routine cleaning that I do as a stay-at-home mom of three little ones. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Becky. I am a wife and mom to, like I said, three little ones, six and under. My son Noah is six, my daughter Hazel is four, my son Wyatt is two, and we are expecting our fourth in April 2024. Here on my channel, I share all things cleaning, decluttering, and organizing. If you feel like that is something you would enjoy watching, I hope you will subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have any cleaning or decluttering or organizing that you need to do around your house, let's do this together. We are starting today in my kids' bedroom, which is pretty messy but very easily cleaned up. First, we're gonna pick up everything on the floor, make the beds, fold some sheets, and put away the laundry that is on their dresser. I wanted to give you a good overview of the room so you can see where we are starting, and once we're done in here, you can see the transformation that happened. I mentioned in the beginning that I am almost 18 weeks pregnant right now with our fourth baby, and I feel like within the last week or so, my stomach has really started to pop. I noticed it in the camera here, and I just thought I would show you the baby bump update. Every morning when I wake up now, I actually feel pregnant, whereas before, when I didn't really have a bump, I didn't feel pregnant besides the terrible morning sickness that I had. Thankfully, that has subsided, but now I have this bump, and when I wake up, I'm like, oh, I definitely feel pregnant. It almost feels like if I were between 24 and 28 weeks pregnant right now, just how my body feels, but I know that is not the case and I still have quite a while to go, but it will go by very fast. Now the beds are made, I have some fitted sheets that I've been putting off folding, so we're gonna get those folded and put away. There is also a pile of laundry on the kids' dresser. It is all shirts, so we need to hang those up as well. Thank you. Hazel decided she wants to be Sally from The Nightmare Before Christmas for Halloween, which I was extremely surprised about because she is all about Disney princesses. Right now she loves Gabby's Dollhouse. She loves unicorns and rainbows and pink and purple, so for her to choose Sally from The Nightmare Before Christmas really took me by surprise. Let me know in the comments what your kids decided they are being for Halloween this year. I think it is so fun. Last year we decided to match as a family. With the kids being a little bit older and all into different things, we definitely wanted to let them do their own thing this year. The last thing we're going to do in this room is vacuum, then we are moving into my master bedroom. The master bedroom is pretty messy as well, but also easily picked up. There's not too much of a mess in here, so the first thing we're going to do again is just pick up the floor. Once everything is picked up, I'm going to take all of the blankets and sheets off the bed, wash those sheets, put new ones on, but before we do that, there were some weird spots on my mattress, and I have no idea how they got there because we do have a mattress protector on my mattress, so once we take everything off, I'm going to pull out my BioClean and get those spots off of my mattress. This was my first time using BioClean on stains that I have no idea how long they've been there, and it worked amazing. Here is Wyatt's costume. He decided he wanted to be Captain America. He was so cute picking out his costume. He was between Baby Shark and Captain America. And when it came down to it and he had to decide, I was like, okay, do you want Baby Shark or Captain America? He grabbed the Captain America costume and ran around the Halloween store yelling, America, America. And I just thought it was the cutest thing ever. We recently started reading superhero books and he just loves the Captain America book, so I am sure that is why he wants to be Captain America for Halloween. Okay, I'm going to show you the stains on my bed now. The two larger ones at the top are from when Wyatt was a newborn. There were two nights, I feel like it was the only two nights that we didn't have a mattress protector on our mattress. It was in the washing machine, and he leaked through his diaper both times. Of course, I have tried to get these stains out before, but nothing has worked. These other stains all over the place, however, I have no idea what they are. They're so sporadic, and we do have two mattress protectors now, so there is always one on our bed. It almost looks like as if I were changing my sheets and one of the kids came in my room and jumped around with some hot chocolate. I guess it could be chocolate or coffee, maybe even one of the kids spilled juice use on my bed, I just have no idea, but either way, we have a mattress protector, so it is all very confusing to me. Anyway, I pulled out my BioClean and we're gonna try to get these off. I am very impressed with BioClean. It did an amazing job. It got out every single small dot that was all over the place and got most of the stain out at the top of the bed. I would say I highly, highly recommend BioClean. At least for mattresses, couches, carpet, I do in a little bit here try it on my headboard because you can kind of see an area on the lower part of my headboard where our pillows would be that looks a little dirtier than the rest of it. I tried the BioClean on there and I feel like it spread the stain upwards rather than taking it out. I will have to pull out my carpet cleaner on a later date to fix that. You will see what I'm talking about in just a little bit. Right now I'm using my fabric shaver to remove all of the fabric pilling that has happened on my headboard. This fabric shaver works amazing. I've used it on my headboard, some blankets, my couch, and it never disappoints. I ended up having to empty it twice while doing this, which you will see as I go. Like I mentioned I was going to do, now I am pulling back out my BioClean to try to get this stain off of my headboard. Since it is a rougher fabric, I decided to use a scrub brush and kind of scrub the BioClean in there to pull the stain out from the inside. Once I scrub it down, I do get out a microfiber towel and wipe it down and try to absorb some of that BioClean. I've seen this method work great before, but it did not work great in this situation. It definitely made it worse. You will see in just a little while. When I'm making my bed, it almost leaves a line where the wetness from the BioClean stops on the headboard and pushes the stain up to that line. I was so confused why this happened. I don't know if it was because I scrubbed it or if I should have just used the microfiber towel and kind of wiped it off. I really don't know, but now I need to pull out my carpet cleaner and carpet clean this whole headboard to try and make it match again. Right now, the goal is to just get it all the same color again. I feel like I still had hope that maybe it was just wet a little bit still on the inside, so I wanted to let it completely dry before I made the decision to carpet clean it, but now at this point, it is dry and the stain is still there. So I will have to carpet clean this headboard at a later date. Thank you. While the mattress and the headboard dry, I'm going to dust, wiping down all of the surfaces in my room and vacuum. My master bedroom is clean, now it is time to make the bed. The mattress is completely dry. The headboard still had a little bit of drying to do, but nothing goes on it, so I wasn't too worried about that. I didn't even realize what was under my mattress while I was making my bed. If you see it, it will make you laugh if you know what it is. We have packed up a lot of our stuff as we prepare to move come December, and my husband must have been smart enough to set something aside. And somebody decided to stay and hide under our mattress. I know there's a lot of moms with little ones that watch my channel, so I'm not going to say it out loud, but if you saw it, like I said, you know what I'm talking about. I often get questions about why I put so many things on my mattress and what each layer is for. So I wanted to explain. Of course, first we have the mattress, then we have a mattress or bed warmer. If you don't know what this is or don't have one, I highly, highly recommend getting one. We got ours a couple of years ago and it has been a game changer. It is so comfortable to get into a nice warm bed at night. If for any reason ours is not on our bed, say we are washing it or something, it is just not the same. Nothing compares getting into a nice warm bed at night. If you live in a colder climate or like me, I live in Michigan. Right now it's fall, but it's very chilly outside. I feel like winter lasts forever. Even springtime is chilly to me. The only time it's warm around here is for about 4 months in summer. But other than that, I am always cold in Michigan. I definitely definitely am somebody who maybe eventually I will move more south because I do not like being cold. I hibernate in the winter. And let me tell you, having a warm bed is just amazing. Like I said, highly, highly recommend. All of that to tell you about the first layer that goes on my bed, my mattress warmer, and then we have a mattress protector, which I feel like as a mom of little ones is essential just in case anything happens. We've even had our kids throw up in our bed, spill stuff on our bed, and it's just nice to have the mattress and the mattress warmer protected. Next, we have the fitted sheet, then the top sheet, and then our quilt comforter, which we got from Target a while ago, and I love it. It is very heavy, but it's also very thin and warm, so I feel like it checks all of my boxes. I love the color of the one we chose, of course, but they do have a ton of other colors to choose from. This is probably a little bit weird, but I love the quilted pattern on it because I'm a little bit OCD about how I make my bed, and it allows me to perfectly align everything so everything is equal on all sides. I cannot explain why I am that way, but it just makes me happy. Once we're done in this room, we're going to go into my master bathroom. There was really no reason to show you a before in here. It wasn't very messy, everything just needed to be cleaned. So we're going to kind of start from the top of this bathroom, work our way down, and then to the left, and then do the floor. Lately, I've been loving using my e-cloth to clean my floors. It's so easy and simple and a chemical-free way to keep your floors clean. All you do is get the cloth wet, wring it out so it is just damp. There's no need to add any additional cleaners. You don't have to worry about your kids walking around or crawling around on it, or even your pets. It cleans and protects your floor, stripping away grease, grime, and dirt, and over 99% of bacteria with these precision-engineered microscopes microscopic fibers. There was a while there where I didn't use my e-cloth at all, besides to like sweep stuff into a pile, but never to mop. I'm not really sure why. I think it's because I didn't think it would do as good of a job as, say, my Tinco or my steam mop or even my Oseeder mop, where you have to add cleaner. But I've been using it a lot lately and have been loving it. Now I'm like, dang, this is so easy. I could clean my walls and my cupboards. I feel like I have so much opportunity with this mop because it makes things so easy. That is not sponsored, by the way. I just wanted to share a product that I have been loving. If you don't have one, you should try one. As a mom, it is so nice to have a quick, easy, convenient way to keep your floors clean. As you can see, we've moved on to the main bathroom in my house, which again was not very messy, but just needed to be cleaned, especially my bathtub and shower. We have hard water and our bathtub often gets stained, so that needs to be cleaned pretty frequently. We'll be doing that, and I'm also tossing some of the kids' bath toys because they've had them for quite a while. Some of them have holes in them, and I don't want them to have mold in them. That can get really, really gross. I'm just being extra cautious by tossing those ones, and the ones that don't have holes and can be cleaned, I'm going to put in the dishwasher. Usually when I'm cleaning my bathrooms, or anywhere in my house actually, I get comments about how I should be changing out my microfiber towels more frequently. So I will often mention in my videos that a lot of my microfiber towels are the same color. I try my best to show you when I am changing out each one, just showing you quickly on camera that I have a new one. I don't always remember to show you on camera when I'm changing, and some of them are the same color. I just wanted to assure you that I do change them out frequently. Barkeeper's Friend is my go-to for cleaning hard water stains. Again, this is a product I highly recommend. I have not found anything else that works as well and as quickly as Barkeeper's. Pumice stones also work, and they have a lot less chemicals. However, there is a lot more scrubbing that comes with using a pumice stone. At almost 18 weeks, I definitely do not feel like being on my hands and knees and scrubbing my bathtub right now, so Barkeeper's Friend it is. The last two things I'm doing in here is changing out the garbage and mopping the floor again with my e-cloth. I will show you this time, once I'm done mopping, how much dirt this mop picked up just in this bathroom alone. The nice thing is you can wring this mop out and keep cleaning as many times as it takes to clean your floor, and when you're done, just throw it in the washing machine. I want to thank you so much for being here and watching today's video. I hope you got some motivation to get up and be productive and get anything done that is on your to-do list today. I know you can do it. I believe in you. If you liked today's video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you again for being here. I will see you in the next one.